this car he has brought us. I also want us to love God and bless him and ask him more of his love and nourish us. Okay. I also want us to bless and ask God to give him thanks for his life upon us. Then I also want us to ask God and thank him and invite the Holy Spirit to intervene for us for this session. Let's just put God before the Lord. Let's thank him because he's our God. He's a God. He was a God yesterday. He is a God today. And still remains God tomorrow. Let's just go before the Lord. Just thank him for anything that he has done to your life. For this level that you are. Just thank him. The bottom level, the top level, the church level. Let's just thank God. God bless you. God bless you. I sense the same for you, the Bible says. As not my hand made all these things, and so they came into being, declares the Lord. These are the ones that live on with him, those who are humble and contrite in spirit, and who tremble at my feet. Praise God. I want us to look at something, have some prayer points on this part of being humble. As youths need to be humble before the Lord. As youths need to be humble before our Father in the church. We are sons of the kingdom, at the same time we are sons of his house. There are things that we need to do. We need to humble ourselves each and every now and then. Oh. We need to show some dignity and honor the church, the elders. And I want us also to do something and ask God. There's something we needed in us, in the church. I want us to pray. I want us to pray and ask God to cleanse us from pride and never be humble each and every day. Pride is the most causes of ever leading as youths astray. And now, therefore, the youths, wherever we are, let's pray that pride will not be part of us, but we'll be humble, receive the favor of God that is there for us. Number two, I want us to ask God to raise sons and daughters who will be humble enough to wait for the God's time. Yes. Let's ask God to raise sons and daughters in this house. This is our church. This is our house. God knows that why we are in this place. And God has something for us. You have to wait for the right time that God will wake us up and God will rise us up. Let's pray that true sons and daughters in this house will be raised up. Those will be there to wait, those will be there to humble themselves and wait the right time for God. And then number three, let us pray that youths in the house to know their role and be committed to serve God with dignity and honor. Praise God. Let's understand where we are right now. If you look at the youth, that kind of life we are living, at times not pleasing. At times we make us decisions, think everywhere is the right thing. But tonight, I want us to ask God that youth in the house, in this house, will know their role and be committed to serve the Almighty God, who is our God. Then number four, I want us to pray that youth will be ready to accept Christ through the other way, not the simple way. Youth will be there to accept Christ as their personal Savior. Now I want us to ask God that the youth we have in the church should be ready to accept Christ. They should be ready to have faith in Christ. They should be ready to be baptized. And they should be ready to listen to the ministration of the Holy Spirit in our lives. Praise God. This also goes to us and all. We should be there to accept Christ. We should be there to go in the direction that the Holy Spirit is leading us to. Then lastly, I want us to pray that youth in this church will not be in and out. They will not be vagabond. The last some 2 days ago we have been praying about the vagabonds. We find a youth is moving from church to church, moving aimlessly, I can say aimlessly. He has no place to settle. He has no church to settle. I want us to pray that God will make sons and daughters in this place, that they will stick in the church to know the role, to know the why they are in this church. Let's go. Let's rise up and thank God, worship God.
Warrior, my any human being is to be planted. God created man, women, and designed them to be planted, both biologically and spiritually. Wandering spirit makes men and women never to bear fruits in their lives. They say that if you are rootless, you become fruitless in life. I repeat, if you are rootless, you don't have roots, you become fruitless. Jesus says in John chapter 15 that if you abide in me and my word abides in you, then you shall do what? Just paraphrasing up verses 4 down there, it says, then you shall bear more fruit. Christ has not just called us to bear fruits, but he wants us to bear much more fruits. So when you are rootless, you become fruitless. When I talk about a vagabond, it's a person without a permanent home. A man or a woman who has no permanent home. He moves from place to place. When you look at it from the Webster dictionary, they talk about a vagrant, they talk about a wanderer, they talk about Trump. Not Trump with R-U, but Trump with R-A-M-P. Trump. A person who is a vagrant, is a wanderer. They talk about, when you look at from a spiritual Bible, says a person who gets intimate with many, but remains with none. Gets intimate with many, but remains with none. A vagabond is one who is contrary to the rule. He does not accept the accepted order. He's always rise up, he's contrary to it. The vagabond. Vagabond is one who is contrary to the rule or the accepted rule of law. There is an accepted order or a general practice, but a vagabond will always depart from the usual pattern and wants his pattern to be the way. He refuses to belong to a permanent organized system. He'll always contend over the system. He wants his own way. God's intention for us is to be planted. It is not easy for us to move to a new level of fruitfulness until we come to the place of belonging, a place whereby you are planted. You need to have roots. Praise the Lord. I pray that God will help us to have roots as members, as sons and daughters in His word, which allow us. I want us to read three scriptures, then we shall develop some prayer points, looking at Jeremiah chapter 17, verses 8, verses 7 to 10. Jeremiah. Another one to open with us, Psalms chapter 1, verses 1 to 4. Then we shall look at another man who talks about the same spirit in the book of Jude, verses 11. Judas, not chapters, but verses 11. We shall look at those three verses, then we wrap it up in our prayer this evening. Jeremiah 17. The people are in trouble. In the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, they're in trouble. And they're asking God questions. Just giving a preview as you'll be reading it at your own time. Jeremiah chapter 17, they're in trouble. They've been praying. They need deliverance and asking God, why are you in our midst? And yet you can't deliver us. Why can't you deliver us? And the prophet gives an answer to the issue and says, talks about Moses. Seven.
But blessed is the man who
that. He likens a man who trusts in the Lord to what? To a tree. What style is that? You know, in English or in the linguistics, they liken, like the Jeremiah is likening a man who trusts in the Lord and has confidence in the Lord to a tree planted by the river. Which style is that? It's a metaphor, yes. He likens human character to other inanimate characters like plants, and says, this man is like a tree planted. The opposite of being planted is having no settlement. That means he's a vagabond. He has no permanent abode. He has no permanent home where he calls home, and says, this man who trusts in the Lord is like a tree planted. Now, some sort of some say, verses 1, chapter 1, verses 1. Praise the Lord. You see, he's still likening this man. And says, this man is like a tree. A tree that is planted at, for example, eucalyptus or a palm tree. Those, even in the Bible, we study trees. One of the funniest trees is a palm tree. A palm tree, if it is 100 meters up the ground, it is 100 meters down the ground. It is directly proportional. So the height it goes is the same height it does what? But some would say that African believers are 100 kilometers up, but 2 kilometers, very shallow, 2 meters actually. They seem to be flourishing up here, but deeper, they don't have what? They're not planted. And that's how when storms come, they do what? We easily fall. And I want to tell us, says, a vagabond species like that, they don't have a permanent abode. These men were asking, Lord, why are you not delivering us? And the Lord says, look here, you are not planted in me. You don't have a permanent abode in me. Kwamba, ikiwa inaonekana nachelewa, then utaenda plan B. He says, they run from one way to another. But he says, we need to be planted. Without being planted, you are a prey. You are unstable. You shall only have an influence if you are planted. And that's what I kept on. Last time I was talking to the worship team. I told them, I don't care how much you are gifted. I care the grace you are grateful. You hear me? There are things even for me to permit for you to preach at this pulpit, the things I look for in you. I don't just look at the gift. I look at some issues inside your heart. Because ministry is about grace. And if you want to thrive, you must plug into the grace, not with money. And some of us want to corrupt pastors. Simply come, okay. It's not about that. Are you willing to be like Elijah and Elisha? There is that grace that comes by closely working together. This is like a tree planted. The storms come, the challenges will come, but what gives this man influence? It is the rooting system. If you want to have influence up here, if this church is going to have an influence in Kenya, in the world, it depends on us being planted. Now, let's see Jude 11, 13. Let's see some what Jude talks about it. Jude 11.
They have taken the way of
Cain. Not the word, the way of Cain. When you say the way of Cain is what? Vagabond. He's a fugitive. Remember, fugitive, he tells us the meaning. He says, Cain, you shall be a vagabond and a fugitive. Go on.
They have rushed for profit into Balaam's error. Mm-hmm. They have been destroyed in Korah's rebellion. These people are these people are blemishes at your love feast, eating with you without the slightest care. Shepherds who feed only themselves. They are clouds without rain, blown along by the wind, autumn trees, without fruit and uprooted twice dead. 13. They are wild waves of the sea, foaming up their shame, wandering stars, for whom blackest darkness have been reserved forever.
Praise the Lord. Now look at how Jude describes these guys. He talks about they have walked. My version says, woe unto them, for they have gone in the way of whom? Cain. Cain, the vagabond spirit, my version says, is a kind of religion that believes in God, but is after personal gain. They don't want to get rooted. They're after what? Personal gain. They want to build a name, a fame. They want to be a celebrity, but they don't want to be what? Rooted. I've met some failures on earth, but I can tell you for free, anything that's done outside church, there's no stand to test for them. Did you hear me? If you're a believer, anything done outside the church circles, it doesn't stand to test for them. Now, Cain talks about four things. One, he says they're like spots in your love feast. They're like a spot in a what? In a love feast. You know what a love feast is? Huh? Okay, don't want to talk about it. Then. Number two, he says like the clouds current about. George, you do a lot of science with clouds and all that. Say, these guys like clouds that have gathered. And what happens? It's like when you boy. But all of a sudden, we can hear that what? What is that? When you tell us. Clouds carried about. Number two, that there are trees whose fruit withers. That's what Cain is telling us. That there are trees whose fruit withers. Huh? Not the leaves that with us inaweka tuna, lakini badala tuna kuwa to become to what? To full age. What happens? You are using the right word. They are raging waves in the sea. They are wandering stars. One day we shall look at it deeper. I told you I'm writing some things about it. You know, when you talk about a wandering star, those who study, you can go and study some few things about astrology. A wandering star. I did African anthropology, and they say a man without roots is like a cockroach. Huh? That's what Africans believe, that a man has roots. In fact, the mindset in Africa, you can't have rootless. That's why cattle offer US. You'll penye pesa itatoka. Na permit pewa wakati COVID inasema hakuna mwili kutoka US kuleta Afrika. Mwili utasafirishwa kutoka wapi? Africa from US. Na uleta wapi? Game. Now shangai, what has happened? How did they go through? They say, move out where you are. You're like a cockroach. You have no place to land. And that's why they work hard to make sure Kwamba they bring you back home. If Africans can do that, how much will the church say? Praise the Lord. In other words, God's design is God wants to build a family. And when people are not willing to belong, these four or five qualities that Jude talks about becomes that they don't belong anywhere. They are on themselves. That's why belonging to a family is very important. God is building a family. And one of the issues he talks about, Ephesians chapter 4, one of the issues about a family is unity. We need to pray tonight that God will unite our hearts together. Have you had meetings where you are seated? Yani, somebody has brought in a very good agenda, and it's like everybody's buying into it, lakini tumuto na tokeanga from nowhere. Huh? Nana bringa tu. It becomes a real issue. What kind of shalani do you? I don't know what shalani do you mean, but then what is it? No. It's a what? It's a vagabond spirit operating inside. And this is what is killing churches in Western Cape. So we need to pray unity. Ephesians 4:11 talks about unity of the church. Praise the Lord. Number two, I'm going to highlight those prayer points. I don't have time to. Now, before I talk about the prayer point, another issue about the vagabond spirit, it empowerizes believers. It empowerizes believers, making them void of spiritual life. When God is speaking a curse over Cain in chapter 4 of Genesis, verses 11, he says, the land shall become what? Unproductive to you. You become impoverished in your heart. They lack humility, they lack meekness. That's one of the issues that vagabond does. It makes people to lack humility. Mbio shamba balo ni mkumu. I tried digging wakati kumekua na kiangazi. Saa hii, enda tu shambani na jembelako. Uresikia mgongo tu wako ni inakwambia na matwene. Wajia kiloko. It empowerizes believers' hearts that making them void of spiritual life. And one of the issues that makes them be void in their hearts is humility and meekness. It empowerizes them of spiritual insight. They can't pursue God's purposes and God's plan at a particular age. And I'm telling you, there is no greater tragedy in life than going through life without fulfilling a particular purpose. Praise the Lord. God has created us to fulfill a purpose. Cain was not only a vagabond, but a fugitive. And I'm saying that a fugitive is one running away from justice. Like Kabuka. I'm going to go Kabuka. Huh? Hey, he kept on running, and I'm told alikuwa ndio anatakapewa namba ya gari ya alikuwa mwanajeshi. He was running because he had a lot of money. There was a lot of money, a lot of gold in his land. So he was running away. There's another one, and some other guys in Africa have been fugitives. And Allah says, Cain, you shall become a vagabond and also a fugitive. One running away from justice. This is what it makes men and women run away from their purpose. And they end up dying useless, just like a dog on the streets. I want us to pray this evening. Already Nani had begun praying some few things that was good for us. One of the issues I want us to pray, let me just highlight the prayer point I want us to pray. One, we talked about unity. Number two, we ask the Lord to plant us in this work. We need planting. Us, our hearts, with our hands, with our legs. As the time was talking about the wisdom of your hands, your lips, your heart, and your legs. We need to be planted. God to plant us in the work with our hearts, with our resources, with our hands, that we shall be willing to serve God in totality. Number two, number three, ask God to raise up sons who shall run with the vision of this work globally. God raise up sons who shall run with the vision of this work. Number four, ask God to make us consistent and reliable workers in this work. Consistent and reliable workers. We shall not look for gain. What's up? Mm-hmm. I don't know if even if God blesses you with money. You have a voice, you can sing. I know you, all of you here. You can sing, you can record music. But let it not be after getting. I know India has recorded her music. Have you listened to it? Have you listened to her music? It's a very nice one. But really, let me tell you, if you go in the way of Cain, money, I was to host one of the trainers in worship here. She's been a good friend of mine for years. I knew her when I was in college, many years ago. You know, she told me, Pastor, how much can you be able to raise? Which hotel are you picking me up at the same community? And the first question she asked me, are they those Muzungu based that are still there? She said, yeah, those are Muzungu based. Let me pray about it and tell you. She needs around 30,000 for her to be here. Just a train. Say it. Me, I will preach anywhere. Like I'm on Talala Kwenyasi. Talala kama nimesimama, utahubiri, utaendelea kuhubiri. More is impact. But don't let me hear that. Ask God to raise up consistent and reliable workers. They shall not go in the way of Cain to look for money. They shall serve God in their hearts. Because when they serve God in their hearts, the Bible says, those who labor. That's Hebrews chapter 13. It talks about those who labor in the house of just professing, they deserve double honor. They shall be honored. That's one of the issues I'm lacking. I'm praying that God will help us here in Jesus' name. Reliable workers, consistent workers, faithful workers, people that are committed in and out of season, they shall be here. Make sure that God's purposes come to pass. Number five, pray that God will birth in us commitment to this cause, to this work. Commitment to the cause of this ministry. And lastly, we pray that God will free us from the bondage of aimlessness. This year, we don't have serious projects. thing that makes a difference. Eh? Not 100 things that you are just seeing the same. One that makes what? A big difference. Praise the Lord. God to deliver us from the bondage of aimlessness. One thing. One thing. And we went over and did it. What was this? Celestial, not Esther. Celestial. There is a lesson in the chat. Good. So you are celestial to me. There is celestial 1, celestial 2, and now you are 3. Good. Praise the Lord. One of the issues about vagabonds, they begin tasks and they never finish. I want us to pray that God will deliver us from that. I want us to pray that God will give us the anointing to start and finish. Praise the Lord. Anointing to do what? To start and finish projects, studies, assignment, and God will be able to do it. We have 10 minutes to pray. Father, we pray tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's stand up and pray. Shalabakata. Shandabu sila laketa. Kabanamu sia talamasai. Ramu talamasete. Dika talamasanka. Ramu. The vision of this work, Miracle Center, shall come to pass. That God will cause it to pass. God will cause it to pass. Let him raise up pastors, men and women that are getting out for church planting in Jesus' name. Number two, I want us to pray that in our church, God will raise up pillars. Men who are givers. There are four things about it, about pillars. Number one, there are people, they are givers. Number two, that implementers. Number three, they are thinkers. Are we good? Yeah. One, I've talked about men and women who are thus, who are what? Who are givers. Number two, who are what? Implementers. Number three, who are thinkers. Thinkers talks about wisdom. Number four, we need encouragers. And number five, we need planners. What's some of the qualities of good pillars? I want us to pray, Lord, raise them up in this work. I want us to pray both locally. There are some destiny pastors from wherever. They can be givers of God has raised up outside there. They could not be members of this church, but God has allowed them to hear what we are doing here. And they say, we want to support this work so that this work becomes that which God intended to be. God, release them to us in Jesus' name. Raise them up in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray. Father, we ask for you. We pray tonight in Jesus' name that the commission of this work shall come to pass. The commission of this work shall come to pass. The commission of this work shall come to pass. Lastly, just make one prayer. Tonight, today was youth day. Psalm 68. Some of you for us was 11. Keep those actually. Psalm 68, 11.
Came some armies, beautifully appears, and she that turned
sets the lonely families. I want us to pray. It's only God who can settle our men and our daughters into marriage. They may desire, but it's only God who can settle them. I want us to pray in 2021. God will settle our daughters in Jesus' name. The chains of darkness holding and delaying their marriages, we want to nullify them in Jesus' name. Right men shall come. Pray that God will settle them tonight in Jesus' name. 2021, we need weddings. This church is known for, among many things, it's weddings. Among many things, there are things that I don't want to mention them. And one of them is many weddings. Father, we pray tonight, settle the Lord. We are praying for our sisters, we pray for our brothers tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you who settles the soul of the lonely, you who settles the lonely families, you who gives men, you who gives husbands, you who gives wives, you who gives men, you who gives mighty wives of God, we pray tonight that you settle them, settle them, settle them, settle them, we pray in the name of Jesus.
Gracias.